Hi folks, this is Peach Mario with the 8th video about the TillyWiki development environment. So now we want to have a closer look at how can someone contribute to our project. Yeah? So here with TillyWiki, I have write access. Yeah? Now I'm logging out and log in again with the PMario user. I'm searching for the TillyWiki project. TillyWiki test project, open it, and then I have here the fork button, yeah, which creates a copy of the whole project and the whole history and everything. Yeah. Since I'm part of different organizations, I can choose where I do want to copy it, and I use PMario here. The nice thing here is that it really copies the whole content, including the history. Yeah, which is part of the .git directory, where we will also have a closer look afterwards. Yeah. And as you can see now, I'm at PMario test. I do have the clone or download button, and I copy the URL to the clipboard. Then I go to my editor, open a new folder, and here I'm at Git. Yeah. What I also did, I did set pin to quick access, yeah, so that I have a faster access now here. If I click the Git directory, I directly go into the directory with the Explorer. Yeah, since the project is also called test here, I do have a little naming conflict. I resolve it like this, so I create PMario directory and TillyWiki directory. Yeah. This may be also useful for you if you, for example, copy or if you clone different projects from other users, so you can nicely separate them without having the problem of naming conflicts. Yeah. So now I go to PMario. I create a new folder here. It's test TillyWiki. It can be any name. And select this folder. Then I say clone with the Git plugin, clone, and copy the URL. Username, password is not needed because we are only reading it. Yeah. What happens now? It downloads everything. Let's have a short look. PMario. And let's show the hidden files. Yeah. So view hidden items. And there you can see there is the .git directory, which is a hidden directory. And this contains everything. So all the history and so on. Yeah. Also, if you mess something up and you don't want to delete your source files, it's possible to just delete the Git directory, and then you get rid of all the history and everything. Yeah, but then you have to clone it again. Yeah, but I just wanted to show you that there is actually, well, where the content actually is. Okay, so this is the new directory where I have write access to. And this is also called origin. Yeah. So in normal cases, this is an alias name, and origin is always the directory where we have write access to. Yeah. The second name, which is very common, is called upstream, or the second alias. And upstream is the repository, let's say the main repository, where all the action happens. We will create upstream link again afterwards, but now just have a look at the origin directory. So I create a new file. Let's go to the folder here. Yeah, so it's possible to create new files and new folders or whatever. So text document stf.txt. Yeah, and you can see now there is a new file, and you have a new untracked file. Yeah. Okay, I want to commit it. Okay, yeah, committed. New file. Then it asks for the new username, because now I'm at PMario, yeah, so I'm using PMario username, and my Gmail account. Then I commit again, and now I can push it. Yeah, and with the last video, I did some global settings, so now I should get a new login, right? Yeah, that caused some trouble with the first recording. So now I need the password. One moment. Oops, it timed out. I was a little bit too slow. Okay, again, push it, copy the password, and PMario. Now it should be used, and now it should push the new content to the PMario account. Okay. Now you can see there is the new file, asdf.txt. But what happens with test? Nothing. Because what we need, that you know already, we need a pull request. So I can say, okay, create a new pull request. And now what did I do wrong? Yeah, I pushed to master. I should have created a new feature branch. Okay, so let's go back, create a new feature branch, create a new branch, the new file branch. Okay, push this one. Origin. Okay. Oops, wrong one. Yeah. So there should be, where is it? Reload. There is the new file branch. Yeah. And with the new file branch, I should create a new pull request. Just edit a new file asdf.txt. I create pull request. And now this comes up as a pull request at TLV. Yeah? And it is PMario, the new file branch. Yeah? And it is compared to the TLV master branch. Yeah? So there is one commit and one file. Yeah. Okay, since this file doesn't contain any content, that's not what the main contributor wants. Yeah? So he doesn't want some empty files. So we have to add some text. We save it. We commit it. And we push it. We push it to origin. Say okay. Okay. So this pull request is already open. If I say reload now, you can see there are two commits. Yeah? So there is a new file and now with some text. And this is important. Yeah? So if you already created a pull request and there is some discussion going on and you want to change something, just change it, yeah, and push it to the same branch where you created the pull request. Yeah? This is important and also a very useful feature. Yeah? And then so when everything works, yeah, then the contributor, or let's say the owner of the project, can merge the stuff, and everything will be okay. Yeah. So this one pull request is here. The branch has no conflict. Okay. Now I'm logging. I sign out as PMario and sign in as TiddlyV again. Yeah. So because TiddlyV is the owner of the project. Now he sees the pull request. There is a new file and the pull request. And there is no conflict, so I have the possibility to merge the pull request. Okay, I merge it, I confirm the merge, and now this is part, the ASDF file with some content, now is part of the upstream repository. Okay, so now PMario has a problem. I'm switching user again, I'm PMario now. So PMario wants to have the new master path or the master branch. So what do we need? We need to connect the upstream repository. So this is upstream, TiddlyV is upstream, with this repository. So I go to origin, I say, well, let's say to the repository button, and I say create a new remote, and I call this one upstream, and I copy the URL, so it's TiddlyV, and now I can switch between them. So my branch, my new file branch, has been merged, no problem. So oops, I check out master again. Now I should get a problem because I do have ASDF there two times again. But let's have a look. So this is a good example if there is a conflict, how to resolve conflicts. Okay, I switch to upstream and then I say fetch all remote and refresh counters. So every remote connection that is connected here will be fetched, which means that it gets all the information, which branches are there and how they look like. So I can actually select them and check them out. So I fetch all the information and I see now there is a difference between my master branch and the upstream branch, upstream master. So I can say git pull, and let's have a look. So the current tracking branch is origin master, and it pulls from another branch, which is upstream master. That's exactly what I want, because now I have differences between my branch and the upstream branch. I always want to have the same content as upstream. Okay, so let's test. Fetch it. And it did it. So no problem actually happened. And now I have everything the same. That's basically how you do a contribution to a different project. What we have to do, first of all, there is the main repository, which is called upstream. Then I signed out and signed in again as PMario. As PMario, I did go to TiddlyV. I did fork the project. Then I downloaded the content with this URL into my hard disk. I gave it a different name. Or let's say a new structure under PMario with TiddlyV, test TiddlyV, downloaded all the stuff and created a new file. First, very important, created a new branch and then created a new file and then push everything. As I pushed the new branch, I was able to create a new pull request against the master of TiddlyV. TiddlyV saw it and could open the pull request. We could have some discussions. We committed several, well, we did several commits to the same project, and then TiddlyV merged it. But then master, the master branch, is different between the upstream and my origin, because I'm PMario now. So that's why I need to connect this, let's say, local repository with upstream. So here I have create new remote. I can give it any new name. And now I have a connection. And I can check out every branch that is part of the upstream repository. Not folder, new branch. And when I switch to master and I did git pull, it got the actual information from the upstream repository. I think this is, an important workflow, because it's always the same workflow. In normal cases, we want to be up to date with upstream, so we need to pull it. Then we do some changes, and the changes need to be done to origin. So whatever I do here, and this is important, and I can also check out different path. So we will have a closer look again how this works with the path and so on with TiddlyWiki itself. But that's the main workflow. If someone else wants to contribute, or you want to contribute to someone else's upstream repository. Have fun and see you next time.